So back salmon fishing, again getting close to the end of the season. This could well be the last cast for salmon, depends on rain. We've still got next week up till the 15th, but it'll all depend on rain. So I'm fishing one of the bigger rivers. It's fallen quite a lot from yesterday, but it's probably a little bit lower than ideal. I'll fish the beat all the way down back to the forestry road. So hopefully, fingers crossed, we might get something. Didn't get anything up here last season. Normally it do okay up here for salmon. Got a few sea trout last year, which I did a video of. So hopefully there might be something about, as I say, it's a little bit lower running off, but we'll have a bash, yeah. So same sort of tactics as I've been using on other little rivers this week. So 12 pound line, and it's basically a it's kind of like a willy gun sort of variant that I've got on. So we'll just have to see if there's anything waiting around in some of these pools. I don't know whether you can pick it up, but the stags are making some horrendous noises over in that forestry. If he was here at night, it'd be quite unnerving, but I'll just try and be quiet. I doubt you'll pick it up. So, but yeah, they're making all kinds of racket, so they'll have that as a backdrop. Anyway, let's get casting in. The weather's all right just now, but the wind's supposed to get up quite strong, so see how we get on. Hopefully there'll be somewhere to fish even if it gets really strong, but we'll just see. So I've done alright this week. One on Saturday evening, just a wee grilse, and then one yesterday, another wee grilse in that really heavy water. I actually walked to the bottom of this beach with the view of maybe fishing here yesterday, but it was just too high. So I went for plan B, just for an hour and a half, 2 hours. So I was really pleased to get one. Not very big, but it was a great scrap. I'm not sure if they've been catching down on the lower river. I guess they have been. There's been a little bit of water these last 2 weeks, so there's been people getting out fishing. The rivers were just all painfully low for a long time. Right. Move along. All quiet. I'm always expecting something in this pool. I've done well in the past in here, but I didn't get anything last year. I didn't get any salmon up here last year. I had one follow. The rest was sea trout, which was pleasing enough. come on. Get up. There we go. Very good shot of it. And just let it rest a minute. Still got plenty of energy. Now lift your hook out, wet the hands, watch this bank because it's deep water down here, I don't want to go in. Alright, whoa. Okay. Alright. One. So just rest for you a wee little bit. Are you ready to go? I think you're ready. I think you're not far off, are you? There you go. Oh, you got you. You got you. Come on, you ready to go? You got your mouse stuck on your neck? That's it. Angry. There we go. There you go. Brilliant. It's always fantastic to catch a salmon, just no matter how, what size. It's always a thrill. Still get as thrilled, I still get as big a thrill as the first time I ever caught one when I first moved here, sort of 17 years ago. Yeah, so just every season it's, you know, if you get one, it's you know, it feels like an achievement because, you know, if they're there, you can catch them, but as we know, the stocks are not what they used to be, so, but there is obviously a good number about, because, well, I've had a few this week for not a lot of fishing, so it's good to see, it's a good sign. Anyway, we'll keep fishing down, see if we get another one. So that fly's worked well. It's not, I'm terrible with fly names, you have to bear with me. It's actually a Girnal Shrimp. It looks a little bit like a Willigung double. Or a Tronic Shrimp. Embarrassing bad pronunciation. It's the one I've used all this week, so mainly orange, jungle cock. It's got a wee bit of sparkle in the tail there. And then it's got a nice bit of a black wing. Good, seems to be doing well. Yeah, that fly just came round the swing into that slightly the deep hole off that bank there. And wham, happy days. It's always nice to get that first fish on a day. Fish with a little bit more confidence, I think, now. Nice wee finner. There you go. So just that grilse, a wee sea trout, and a few out of season brown trout so far. Pleased with. Oh, cracking. Oh, that's really cool. Oh, there you go. And still we walk. Nobody can say we don't put effort in trying to tangle with these fish that migrate our rivers. Certainly a lot of walking involved. It's really nice. Turning out okay now. Looks like there's another rain shower coming though. Lovely and autumnal. Nice and clear. Fish on from all the filming. How did I not have that in the net? Look at that, Matt. Got tennis elbow in my arms, really struggling. Yes, I've hurt my elbow and that was really hard to lift the net up there. Right, I'm going to have to lift this fish out. I'll try to unhook all the other ones in the water. But this one, I'll just pop it down here. Oh, you've still got some fight in you. Stay there. Yeah, so I wasn't recording because I don't think I've ever encountered anything on this stretch. So I was thinking I'll be. And then typically, let's try and rest here. Right, let's let you go. Oh, mate. We'll just wait with it. And on you go. Down there. Oh, I wasn't expecting that, as I say, just took the fly just off the surface, a big swirl. So went back fine. I had plenty of strength, it was flapping about like mad. I was trying to unhook all the other ones I've caught in the water, but it's just not possible here because it's so deep at the edge, it's dangerous. So hopefully it wasn't too bad. Fairly quickly out. It was a little bit awkwardly hooked underneath and it got stuck in the net, but got it out, and a couple of quick pictures with it in the net, not handling it apart from to get the hook out. And then I was trying to be really minimal with it, so hopefully that came across okay. You understand how precious they are, so trying not to touch them too much. And I've just, any photos I've got this season, just been getting in the net. So we've got a bit longer to go yet, so maybe we'll get another one, you never know. Now that fly, still life in that fly yet. Give it a wet and it'll be all right. Oh, doing really well. Oh, I was really struggling to lift the net there. As I say, I've hurt my left elbow. Apparently it's, physio says it's tennis elbow, she's pretty sure it is. So I think it's a mixture of, started hurting when I was fishing a competition in May. I was stripping flies like for the whole day, and it was a bit sore after that. And then obviously with my work as an electrician, quite often using the hands, so a lot, put it mildly, so can't really not use your arms. So it's hopefully this close season I'll give it a rest and carry on with some of the exercises I've been given. But yeah, I was really struggling to lift that net. It's a funny sensation. You kind of feel like you've lost a little bit of strength in your arm. Anyway, oh, at least we got it in. It's a good one, that. That's the usual kind of stamp of the ones you get up here. Yeah, you get a mixture. There was a 35-pound salmon caught, or probably over 10 years ago, by somebody down, I think, lower down in the river. I don't think I'd ever want, I'm not sure I'd ever want to hook something like that. Obviously that there, the exception rather than the rule. But it was a beast of a salmon, so did well to get it in. Oh, there's another one.